Now, you must be wondering if hacking is similar to stealing. Doesn't that make hacking a bad thing? Worry not, because hacking can be used for good. Based on what your intentions are, hacking is divided into two parts: ethical hacking and unethical hacking. The house example you saw in the previous video was an example of unethical hacking. The thief's motive was to steal wealth, and he misused his knowledge and skills to enter your house. So, when a hacker uses his knowledge to steal from or cause damage to other people, it is known as unethical hacking. Like stealing, unethical hacking is also a crime, and if caught, the thief will be arrested and tried in court. Now, to understand ethical hacking, let's revisit the house example. So the thief has stolen all the money. A few days pass and you come back to your house and you see what has happened. You analyze the situation and conclude that the thief must have entered through the window. You report the incident to the police, but you want to do something about it yourself. You make a plan to prevent such kind of thing from happening again. You contact some home security professionals and ask them to secure your house. The security professionals take your permission and start surveying your house. They do the same thing that the thief did. They start looking for possible entry points, anything that can be exploited to enter your house. After they are done, they give you a report and say that these are the security loopholes in your house. And they also give you solutions to fix the loopholes. For example, loophole: the windows are breakable as they are made of glass. Solution: add grills to all the windows in your house. Or loophole: the code of the locker is easy to guess. Solution: change the code to something that others won't be able to guess. These security professionals then also suggest some additional security measures to further strengthen the security of your house. For example, while going out, lock the doors of the rooms too. This way, even if someone is able to enter the house, he can't simply get in the room where the locker is. This is what is called ethical hacking. When the hacker helps organizations or individuals with finding security loopholes and fixing them with their permission, it is referred to as ethical hacking. And this is legal because you take permission from the system owner and your motive is not to cause harm or steal, but to secure the system. So, those were the fundamentals of ethical and unethical hacking. Now, let's look at the legal side of it. According to the Indian Cyber Law and the Indian IT Act, an activity is considered a cybercrime if a computer is being used to attack other computers, for example, hacking, virus or worm attacks, DOS attacks, etc. A computer is being used as a weapon to commit real-world crimes, for example, cyber terrorism, IPR violations, credit card frauds, EFT frauds, pornography, etc. This basically means that unlawful use of any computer or device is considered a cybercrime. You can read more about these cyber laws and acts online. The house theft scenario we shared was to give you an idea of fundamentals of hacking. In today's world, the systems aren't as simple as a house and the assets are not just gold or money. Due to the technological advancements we have made, systems have become much more complex and information has become the real asset. The whole web works on the basic principle of information exchange. Your username and passwords, your account balance, your personal data, everything is digitally stored information. If this private information gets in the hands of somebody who is not supposed to have it, then it becomes a problem. Hence, securing the information becomes a top priority. This is what we mean by information security. Hope you're starting to learn to understand what hacking is. Click on the next button to proceed.